Good morning, everybody. Today is a pretty exciting day. We've got a fair amount to talk about because yesterday, the LEGO Legacy team announced their LEGO Legacy Content Creator Program, as you see on the screen here. So grab your coffee, your tea, let's discuss. Now, it's important to talk first about what the point of this program is supposed to be. What I have in front of you is the deck that the team released on Discord yesterday at 2 p.m. There was then a roughly 30-minute long Q&A where people from the community got to voice opinions, ask questions, and make sure to clarify points about the information presented by the managers and the creators of the deck and the people who will be presumably running the program. So I've had a time to actually go through this deck and sort of think about how it works. Greedo's, another very active community member, also made a video going through this. I'm gonna go ahead and link that video in the chat for everybody. I'm also going to be putting it in the description on the YouTube version of this video that goes up later. So, I think that this deck has actually been constructed backwards. So we're going to start at the end, but first, as I mentioned before, let's talk about what the LEGO Legacy Creator Program is for. The Discord community managers basically described the Creator Program as a way for those of us who are creating content about the game to receive official assets in the form of images and backgrounds and maybe audio files and things like this that we can use to buff up our streams or make our videos more robust, more official looking. In addition, they will be providing us information about updates that we can use when we make videos and discuss all of these things that just make our videos more helpful for you, the viewer. So that's the point of the program. It's all free, nobody's getting paid for any of it. It's just for those of us who want to be creating content. I say us because I'm including myself as a content creator. I have yet to actually be accepted into the program. Everybody has yet to be accepted into the program. They just announced it yesterday. They have an application process that you have to go through in order to become a content creator. And they mentioned in the chat yesterday that they won't actually be making decisions about who gets to be a content creator until next week. So let's actually start at the end of the deck that they provided. As you can see, it is several pages long, not too long though, and go backwards because I think that the relevant information actually comes in the wrong order. So we're gonna go backwards. Thank you. You're welcome. Previous page. So what does an ideal applicant look like? First off, they make videos. The frequency of posting these videos is roughly twice a month, perhaps more than that, as they allude to in a previous page. This makes total sense. If you're streaming, you're probably making more than two videos a month easily. If you are a YouTube content creator, you're also probably making two videos a month. I think that this is a good baseline because they don't want to just completely flood the market with random pieces of content, especially if most of them are garbage. So I think that this is a good way of them acknowledging that the people who are going to be creators in this program are actually regular content creators. They want you to be energetic, positive, relatable, their target audience demographic. Great, so they want you to be a neat person. Cool. Content type, tips and tricks, tutorials, let's plays, live streams, etc. This is basically what they're saying is the type of material they want you to create if you are chosen to be a content creator. I think this all makes perfect sense. Most of the people who successfully stream for a reason. And it is usually one of these reasons that they've alluded to up here. So that shouldn't be too hard. Platforms, are you only on YouTube? How about Twitch, Instagram, and Twitter? Basically what they're saying here is the more platforms you post to, the better. And that makes sense from their perspective. If you're gonna be creating content that they presumably are gonna wanna share out with the community, especially if your content is good, then they would love for your content to be in more than one place. Here's what you have to do to be a content creator. post at least 2 videos per month relating to LEGO Legacy. That seems kind of like a no-brainer. Theme at least 1 video to each update. I think the V here is just a typo. And this also makes sense. Obviously, if they are going to be releasing updates and you are creating content about the game, you would want to create content about the update, so this should also be a no-brainer. Remain an active voice within the community. Solid. If you are going to be creating content, then they want you to remain active in the creation of your content, whether it's on the Discord server or on your live stream, on YouTube, etc. And you must be compliant with LEGO and legal policies. Now, I asked about this in the discussion because I have yet to actually see the LEGO or legal policies, aside from the ones that you have to agree to when you decide to play the game, which is, you know, basically that they can grab your information the same way that all the rest of these games do, because they have to hold accounts for you and all that other kind of stuff. So nothing nefarious here, but the reason why they put this in here is because if you get chosen to be a content creator, you do have to sign an NDA. That's a non-disclosure agreement, for those who don't know. And when you sign an NDA, it is designed to be a legally binding contract that prevents you from just giving away trade secrets. And in addition to that, you're going to have to be compliant with the LEGO and legal policies, which they've stated they will give you if and when they decide to accept you as a content creator. I suppose if they refuse to admit you into this program, then why would you need to see the legal policies? You won't be beholden to any of them. So that's why they did it that way. All in all of this makes total sense. So what do you get? The creators get exclusive assets to use in their videos every single update, including update-related backgrounds and minifigure poses. We went over this just a second ago. Minifigure poses. Update-related backgrounds. So if they're going to be releasing a new city event or something like that, then they might have a new city background that's going to go into the game, and they might give that to you as like a high-res file for you to include in your stream or your video or whatever your artwork is that you're making. Update themed frame and banners for text layovers so that you can actually theme your entire project with whatever this update's going to be. Exclusive official content creator badge. It's always nice to be official. And much more! What could it be? I don't know yet. There were lots of questions about what this and much more could be, and I think they put this in here because they actually don't entirely know what the and much more is going to be yet, which makes sense. This program is going to be brand new. And once they see all of the content that their community is making, it'll probably adjust what this and much more means. Again, I think it's only positive stuff that could be in here. I don't think it's anything nefarious. So I'm on board. Now, here is where we get into some serious dissension. As part of the program, they've initiated this tier system. You apply for the program, and upon getting selected, you will be placed in either the bronze, the silver, or the gold tier based on the number of followers you have. Now, this isn't just like LEGO followers, this is total followers. So if you're on Instagram and you have 20,000 followers because you're a fitness guru or something like that, then you go straight into the gold tier because you have 20,000 followers. Despite the fact that you might know nothing about LEGO, which begs the question, how would they actually accept you as a content creator if you know nothing about LEGO or the game? But let's say, for example, that they do. All that matters is the total number of followers that you have across all of your social and streaming. All that matters is the total number of followers you have over all of your social and streaming and media platforms. Okay, they don't all have to have come from the LEGO game. Now, this raises a lot of questions and has a lot of concerns within the community. That video that I posted for Greedo, if you're in the live chat, it's up here. If you're on YouTube, it's down here. Greedo went into this very well, I think. So take a minute and watch his video if you haven't already. But I share all of his concerns. Just to ballpark them, the LEGO community right now is relatively small. The LEGO game itself has under 3,000 followers right now. I think it was at 2.5K yesterday when they announced this, which means LEGO itself would fall into the silver tier. And they've already made several memes about this. But more importantly than that is what you get at each tier and why you would want to be in each tier. And I'm going to discuss, as we've already been doing with the deck, the tiers backwards. And the reason for that is because it seems like what you get at the gold brick tier is stuff you just should be getting the whole time. Which begs the question, why do they have the tiers at all? So first let's go over what it is you get. Then let's go into like a brief sort of analysis. I'm going to try to do it from the content creator perspective and what I think they might be thinking from their business perspective. So, gold brick tier, the highest tier, you get everything, but the special things you get is that they will share your video content on the LEGO Legacy Hero Unboxed social media, and you will receive exclusive teasers for events and updates and access to assets to tease them. That's what it says behind my camera. Now the last sentence, receive exclusive teasers for events and updates and access to assets to tease them. And the one before it. Both seem like things that they would have a vested interest in just giving to everybody. Because if your video or your stream or your art or whatever it is that you're making is good and worth sharing, then you'd think they would want to share it regardless of how many followers you have. One, because when LEGO Legacy shares something on their social media, the people who see it are going to be people who follow LEGO Legacy. So if you have one follower or 10,000 followers or a million followers is kind of irrelevant for this particular point because it's going to be shown on LEGO Legacy's social media. So the people who see it will be the followers of LEGO Legacy regardless. So if LEGO Legacy has 2,000 followers, and let's say all of them log in at the exact right time to see whatever this content is that they've shared, and it comes from somebody who only has 10 followers, okay, well, that's still 2,000 LEGO Legacy followers that are going to see it. And if there's a million, if this person, this content creator has a million followers, then it's still 2,000 people who follow LEGO Legacy that are going to be the people who see it. Now, the only difference here is that the person with a million followers is going to get more people to see this content outside of what LEGO Legacy does with it. So in this particular case, it kind of seems irrelevant, right? If the content is good, you'd think that they would want to share it regardless of who it comes from, especially if they've already done some sort of preliminary background check on you to make sure you're not a creep and you've been accepted into the program anyway. So this seems like a reward that should be right from the start. Now, from their perspective, I would imagine that they view this as an incentive to try to get people with more than 10,000 followers to start creating content for the game by basically saying to them, hey, if you bring that big of a community to us, then we will help by sharing your content in a way that we are presumably not sharing other people's content. So it seems like a pretty smart marketing tool, especially because it doesn't cost them anything. So if it works and it costs them nothing, it's a big win. I don't think this is nefarious at all. It makes total sense from a business perspective, from that specific business perspective. It's just very short-sighted. In my opinion, I think that there are other things they could offer people that have over 10,000 followers. Because basically what you're trying to do here is get somebody who's not already playing the game to start playing the game. Because none of the people currently playing the game have over 10,000 followers. None of them. They talked about that yesterday. So what is this for? Exclusive teasers for events and updates and access to assets to tease them? Cool. Great. But this plays into the other tiers. Going into silver, 1,000 to 10,000 followers, assets provided 48 hours pre-update launch to assemble content for the launch day. Basically, what this is saying is that before an update, they will provide you assets so that you can get ready for the update. And then on launch day, you can have well-manicured and put together content to release on your stream or your video or your artwork. This is brilliant, but again, this is something that it seems like should be offered to everyone. And here we raise a different point that Greedo talks about too. To summarize, you only need to watch a video about something once. For example, how many videos are there about how to kill Ragnaros in World of Warcraft? A million? If you need to figure out how to do that, you only have to watch one video, and once you've watched that video, you don't have to watch a whole bunch of other ones. So in this case, if somebody actually has access to this content 48 hours earlier than everybody else, then once the update happens and then everybody else releases content, it's already irrelevant content because somebody else has already made a video on it that presumably you can already watch. Now, if all of this is released on launch day, then we have another problem, because that means that the people in the Silver Brick category are going to have better looking content, or at very least more official looking content, since they had the time to assemble it ahead of time. Make sense? If you have any questions about it, put it in the comments section on YouTube or put it in the stream chat and we will discuss it now. So now let's get into the bronze tier and the basic stuff that everybody gets, because it seems like, oh, well, we should do bronze first because it's included in all the other ones, except that you'll realize it's kind of standard and straightforward, which is good, but it's kind of stuff that you would assume. Receive update specific assets on the day of an update. Great. So silver gets them 48 hours before, bronze gets them the day of, meaning if you want to step up that content, you have to do it that day, and you got to do it fast if you're in the bronze tier, because someone in the silver tier is going to beat you. You'll be recognized on Discord as a creator. If the community doesn't already recognize you as a creator, this is nice. For people like Sicko, Bricks, and Greedo, the community already knows that they're creators, so they'll have much less of a benefit from this because everybody already knows them. But for everybody else, it could be nice, right? Help buff up your stream, make you feel more official, get more visitors to your YouTube channel. Weekly creator news blast from the GCM on Discord. If there's actually news every week that's worth reporting, then this is great and it makes total sense. If your content creators are making the content, you need to give them the information to disseminate to the masses, as it were. Exclusive assets recognizing you as a creator. I think we did show this on a previous page where they give you badges and things like this, which is nice. Everybody likes a sticker. So, how do you apply? We'll put in a call out on Discord. Creators will be sorted into three tiers. All who want to apply must send a filled out form to Will, including all of this information. It's all pretty standard. Your name and your email, your in-game name and player ID, right? They want to see who you are in the game. Social channels, Discord ID, they want to see what kind of stuff you're posting already. Links to past content and why you want to be a part of the program. Now, I'm sure that this is a typo, because what this actually says is, why would you want to be separated from the program? But I think it's supposed to be a space part, because syntax. So I'll be filling this out in the next couple days, turning it in, and I will let you know if and when I hear anything from them. So that's it. That's the content creator program in a nutshell. I think generally speaking, it is a good thing. I think that we're going to see major changes to this tier system because I think it makes relatively little sense. And they have received so much pushback from it just immediately, and they seem to be pretty responsive, that I have a feeling that we'll see some significant changes to the tier program before this unfolds, and then in addition, during the course of the life of the program, I think it'll change significantly. So that's the content creator program.